This video is a follow-on to the Python project where we wrote a loan analyzer class, and you will need that to work through this tutorial. So if you haven't yet, you may want to watch part one, and the link is here and also in the description. I'm going to make the code available as well on GitHub, and that link will also be in the description. Okay, so our application is going to be a simple menu-driven application, and when you run the program, right, you're going to be presented with this menu, and we'll just sort of run through what it's going to do, and then we'll go ahead and write the code to implement this. So first thing we're going to do is start a new loan, and I'm just going to start entering some parameters here, and then it's going to give us a message, right, that we initialized our loan, and now we can run through the other options in the menu. So if we just want to see the payment, we get that, and I built a little delay in there so it doesn't just kind of race by, so it's just using sleep. I'm going to display an amortization table. Okay, we can see a little summary of the loan. If we want, we can make a graph of the declining balance. Okay, and then we have a couple of special methods in our class that show us how to pay off the loan more quickly. So if I choose 6 and I want to get paid off in 10 years, then it tells me how much extra I have to pay and what the total of my payment plus that extra is. And then if that's a little too much, maybe we'll be a little less ambitious and see what happens if, say, we add an extra $200 a month to this particular loan. And when we do that, it gets paid off almost 5 years early. Okay, and then finally, to get out of this, we're going to use the quit option. Okay, so why don't we go ahead then and start writing that application. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is some imports here. So I'm going to need that loan class that I wrote. I'm going to use sys to exit the application, and then I'm going to use sleep. So pretty minimal imports here. All right, and that's just more really for aesthetic purposes than anything else. Okay, so then the next thing I'm going to do is set up that menu, and I'm going to do this, most of this in some simple functions. All right, so I'll just call this one display menu. Okay, to get some formatting in there, I'll just use a doc string. And then the first option is going to be start a new loan. All right, and actually I'll add a little visual there to kind of add an effect to our table. All right, next thing I'm going to do is show a payment. We can show amortization table and the rest of the options. Okay, so that's going to be our menu here, and then eventually I am going to execute some of these functions inside a main function, so I might as well then start setting that up. Okay, and then, so the most basic, right, I'm just going to call display menu on that, all right, and then we just need to tell Python to run this, and I'm going to allow it to run from pretty much any environment, all right, so to allow that, I'm going to add a mechanism to handle that. Okay, so we can try that, and then, you know, all it should do is display the menu and exit at this point. So I'm going to right click here and select the file to run. And as expected, okay, it shows the menu and then exits. Okay, so we're going to then go back to our code and start adding some of that functionality. Okay, so I'm just going to define functions names here that sort of line up with the menu options. Okay, so first or second thing we can do is display a payment. Okay, and I'm just going to put in placeholders initially, and then we'll come back and write these functions. All right, the second thing we can do is amortize. Okay, we're going to show a summary. We're going to plot stuff. We're going to pay it faster. And we're going to pay it early. Okay, so eventually we're going to have to define all these, but I'm going to just start with these placeholders. And then, main should come last here. So let me move that. Okay, so just a convenient way to separate the program flow from the program logic, all right, and it just makes for cleaner, easier to manage code later. Or that's the goal anyway. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do then is sort of make a switching dictionary here to allow us to run each one of those functions based on some user input. Okay, so I'm just going to call this the action dictionary, and right, we're going to have numerical data here, right? But it's going to come in as a string because I'm going to get it as an input. And I'm going to handle the first option where we set up a new loan a little differently. All right, we could put it in here, right? But I'm just going to start at option 2. All right, and so option 2 then is the payment. All right, so I'm just going to refer to that function name. Then we're going to have 3, which is, I name that function amortize or amort, right? We have 4, which was the summary. Okay, I'm going to leave the parentheses off these. Okay, so there's our sort of action dictionary. And then I will come down into main and start setting up the program flow. Okay, so after we display a menu, I am going to capture some user input. Okay, and once I capture the user input, then I'm going to use some conditional logic to decide what to do with that input. All right, so if the choice is 1, we're going to start a new loan, and we're going to need some input from the users to do that. So I'm going to capture a rate. We'll get the term, and then we'll get the loan amount. Okay, so with those 3 inputs, then we can instantiate a loan object, right, using our loan class. Okay, and it's going to need a rate, a term, an amount. Okay, and if we want, we could change the start date. I'm gonna leave that off for now, and I'm just going to pass in the required parameters. The start date assumes it's today. Okay, and then just so the user sees something is happening, we're going to just print kind of a confirmation message here. Okay, sounds super official. And then we're going to sort of sleep for a little bit so that the menu doesn't appear immediately. All right, so I'll just sleep for a second. One of these choices is pretty simple to code because that's the one where we want to exit. So that's going to be an elif. And I don't need to put this in the action dict because I'm just going to use sys and exit here. So I'm going to stick all this stuff actually inside a while loop that just keeps running until, right, you select choice 8 here. And before it does that, we will print a little goodbye message. All right, so let's stick all this stuff in a while loop. Okay, and so then now all we need to do is to add in the logic to execute any of those functions, and then obviously we need to write those functions. All right, so let's put the logic in. It's pretty straightforward, right? That's going to also be elif, and the choice, basically the same thing is going to happen on each of those menu choices 2 through 7. So I'm just going to look at if the choice is in. All right, and then when it is, we'll get an error if there's no loan. So the first thing we're going to do is to try. All right, and what we're going to try is that action dictionary and then the choice that has been chosen. And there's those parentheses, right? And we're going to pass in the loan. Okay, and once it runs it, we're going to add that little sleep in so that, again, the menu doesn't immediately appear and hide our output. So I'm going to put that there. Okay, and if the loan hasn't been set up, okay, that's going to raise a name error. Okay, and if we raise a name error, it's going to sort of get out of here and it's going to start running that menu again. And so now I'll just put in a little message here. And when there's this name error, we'll say that no loan is set up. Choose option 1 maybe. Or some other message that that you like better. All right, and again, I will give people a chance to read that. Hopefully a second is long enough. Okay, so this should be enough again to sort of test at least the flow. All right, so the flow should be completed. Let's try it. Okay, so here's our menu. If I choose option one, it's going to ask me for those inputs, right? If I choose option eight, it's going to exit. If I choose anything else, and I'm going to choose one of these things first, we should get that message that says, okay, the loan hasn't been set up yet. All right, so that should happen no matter what I choose there. All right, and so it tells me to choose option one, so let me do that. Okay, and then let me enter just a few values here. All right, and then okay, one little problem here, right? I am passing in numerical values, and when you use the input function, the input is always accepted as a string. So I'm going to have to do some recasting of interest rate, term, and amount borrowed. And we've already exited, so let me just go back and make those changes. Okay, and so maybe this should be a float. This can be an integer. And I guess this should be a float just in case somebody's worried about the pennies on the end. All right, we'll allow that. Okay, and so that should get rid of that error. And the next thing we need to do then is to define some of these functions. And most of them are pretty simple, right? Most of them are just one line of code. And these are going to be accessing the methods in that loan class that we imported. Okay, so here we're just going to print, and the loan class has a method, right? And you can see all of the methods here. All right, and there's one called a payment string, and I'm going to call that. And this just puts out a nicely formatted payment. Okay. All right, so next is the amortization table. And again, we're just going to print and loan. And this is the table. So the summary is a little different because the method written just prints out some values. So all we actually have to call on this is loan.summary. Okay, so moving right along into plot. This one, just call plot balances. And then the last two are a little bit more involved, right? Because we have to get some input from the user. How fast do you want to pay it off? So that'll be the first step here. All right, so we'll get an amount, and we'll get a float there, and it'll be an input. And then it's just some kind of prompt, enter years to be debt free. All right, so this is going to be how long you want before you pay off your loan. Okay, and then I'm going to store a result here, and that's going to be in the loan.retireDebt method. Okay, and I'm going to pass in this amount. Maybe that's not a great name. Let's call it years. Okay, so now I've stored the result there, and this result is a tuple, and it gives us how much extra to pay, and then the sum of the regular payment plus this extra. So we'll print that out, all right, put it in an F string, and we'll talk about what the monthly extra is, and that'll be the result. Okay, so result 0, the first element in that tuple, and then I will format as a comma separated floating point number, right? And I suppose we can put the dollar sign on front of that if you want. And then I'll just put a tab in between these two things, and total monthly, and that's going to be result 1, again comma separated, and then we should be done with that one. Okay, one more. We're going to pay early now, and for this one, yeah, we'll take in that amount, and again it's going to be an input. And let's start by making it a float and an input, and then enter monthly extra. So you're going to commit to paying the same amount every month extra. And then when you do that, we are going to get a new term. All right. And it's going to be based on loan.payEarly. And the required input there is this amount. All right. And then once we do that, we're going to just print off how many years you pay off the loan in. So again, an F string. We'll get the new term in there, and we should be done. All right, I'm going to add one more line here, right? And essentially what we're going to do is catch bad input. Okay, so if they type in anything outside of 1 through 8, we're going to get this message and the menu should display again. Okay, so let's try it out. Okay, and just test that we're getting what we expect here. All right, so choose option 1. Let's do that. 5%, 30 years, 500,000. Okay, we have a loan, and then we can start. And right away, we get this unexpected error. Okay, so nothing to do here but go back and fix it. So it's basically saying that, you didn't tell me that I needed the loan there. All right, and so I'm just going to go back up here and tell it that, we need to pass in the loan. All right, and we actually need to do that for all of these because I'm going to get that same error message every time I call one of these menu options because in the flow of the program, I told it needs this loan. All right, so anywhere I am accessing that loan class, I'm going to pass in that initialized loan. Okay, let's see if that fixes it. Okay, so we'll just jump right away to setting up a new loan at 5%, 30 years, and 500,000. Okay, so we have a loan initialized. Let's see if we can get a payment now. And there's our payment. There's our menu. Let's make sure all these work. There's our amortization. Here's our summary. Okay, the plot. Okay. And then the specialized features here. So let's pay it off. Oh, I think I have the wrong prompt there, or I put the wrong. Let's see what we get here. Let's see. Okay, so I think I just misplaced the menu choices. Okay, and so we'll just make that one final choice. All right, and then right these outputs will make more sense. Let's get out of here, and let's see what did I do. Okay, yeah, so 6 should be pay faster, and then 7 should be pay early. All right, maybe not the best names, but you with better imaginations can come up with better ones. Okay, one more time. Same loan, 5, 30 years, and 500,000. And then we'll just test those last two. So 6, how many years? 10, right? And then, okay, there's the output we were expecting. And then 7, monthly extra. Let's give it a little bit extra. And we're going to pay it off in 24 years if we can throw an extra $300 at that problem. Okay, so there is our quick menu-driven application to finish up this Python project where we're analyzing loans. Now, there are a couple of improvements that are fairly obvious, I guess you could add, and I'll leave it up to you to do that. Probably you'd want to edit some of those parameters, right? So once we initialize a loan, can we go back and say change the interest or the amount borrowed or the term, right? You'd want to be able to do any of that. And you'd probably want to be able to compare maybe two different loans directly. All right, so basically working around some of the same code we already have, and since we set up a class that does this, right, it should be pretty easy to actually implement some of those improvements. All right, so I hope that helps you get started writing classes and then menu-driven applications based on them.